question for all of you who think that a car is more than a point A to point B experience. What did Mazda and Audi have in common years ago? Well, they were both known for putting rotary engines in cars. Now, why did the rotary engine die off? The way it was built and the size to power ratio and the simplicity made it like look like that it would last forever. Well, it should have, and with more research and time by the two companies, it would be something more common to see today. The Cosmo Sport, which Mazda released in 1967, was the planet's first dual rotary engine. With its futuristic styling and superior performance, the Cosmo wowed car enthusiasts worldwide. After that, Mazda began putting rotary engines in their sedans and coupes in 1968, which would hit the US market in 1971. But as the invention became more and more common, more people jumped on it. GM Motors tried to jump on the rotary hype with the Aerovet XP 895 in the 70s. With the intentions of it being a mid-engine super Corvette. However, due to the fuel crisis, financial cost, and the rotary program was scrapped at GM, and the four-rotor car was replaced with a conventional V8. And then there were companies like Audi, which stayed in the rotary game for a while and later dropped out. To get to form an opinion on the two types of engines, it'd be nice to know how they work. A combustion engine has to do four things. It needs to suck air into the engine, it needs to compress that air with the fuel mixture, ignite the mixture with the spark, and expel the burnt mixture out the exhaust. The engines under the hood of most cars do this process using pistons. Fuel is sucked in to the piston, then the piston goes down, sucking air into the piston, then it goes back up, compressing the air-fuel mixture, and then the spark ignites it, pushing the piston back down, and on its way back up, it expels the mixture out the exhaust. And the rotary engine, on the other hand, doesn't need to do this up-down motion. It goes in one direction the whole time, and the majority of the process is the same. Air comes into the chamber, it is then compressed, then a spark ignites the mixture, and it is expelled through the exhaust. And with the rotary engine, there could be three steps happening in the same rotor housing. So, now on to the pros and cons. Better to start off with the one you're most familiar with. The traditional cylinder engine, in most cases, is reliable and can be used with a variety of applications. Most commonly in an inline or V formation. They don't burn a lot of oil and they can be made very economical and have relatively good emissions. The downside is that there's a lot of parts and on top of that a lot of moving parts creating reciprocating mass. This term means that they are rev limited due to the danger of valve float. Piston engines are also very big and heavy. They weigh down a car. As to the rotary engine, it is very compact. Very compact, and meaning you can put it into any engine bay with room to spare. And it also means it's lighter and doesn't weigh down the car as much. And the power to size ratio is unbeatable. Rotary engines also have fewer parts. In the case of a simple rotary engine, there's only two moving parts. And the rotary engine also has no reciprocating mass, making it smoother than any traditional engine, and has the ability to rev higher. They also create a unique sound that car enthusiasts know and love. The downside is that they burn a lot of oil because they inject oil directly into the chamber via throttle control, into the rotor housing to keep the seals lubricated and the chambers separated. So if you're not on top of maintenance or use the wrong grade of oil, it is not uncommon to run a rotary engine dry. And because the combustion chamber is so big, portion of the air fuel mixture won't get burnt, thus creating bad emissions. And the trade-off is that the exhaust will tend to spit flames, which car enthusiasts like. But as you can see, these two engines have their pros and cons. And as more studying is done, they both continue, they improve with time. And I'm not saying one is better than the other. I'm saying they're both good, and it'd be nice to see more rotary engines around today. The rotary engine was a good idea that came a little too early. The engine came around before the technology and knowledge to support it was around. Many companies tackled it in the 70s, but it was too unfamiliar and new. But what was failed to see was that the first piston engine wasn't perfect either. The first stationary gasoline engine developed by Carl Benz was a one-cylinder, two-stroke unit, which ran for the first time on New Year's Eve in 1879 and was less than one horsepower, 2.75 to be exact, so it wasn't fast. It didn't have good emissions and it didn't have good fuel economy, but from there we've improved greatly. Now companies have learned to make the rotary engine better, cutting down on the emissions and making it burn through less oil. And Mazda has made iconic rotary engine cars that people love and drive to this day, like the RX-7. So when Mazda released the news that they figured out how to complement the rotary engine with electric engines, with the RX Vision concept, it had people on the edge of their seat. There's no good reason to scrap the rotary engine. After all, we gave the piston engine more than 100 years to improve. I would hate to say it is because companies now are too focused on profit margins, but if we looked at it like we did the electric engine, it took years and a lot of people scrapping the idea to become what it is today. Electric cars were around since the early 1900s and had its moments like the rotary engine. It wasn't until 2006 when Tesla took the idea, made it big, and made people consider electric cars. This is what Mazda is trying to do with the RX Vision concept. So why neglect the idea of a rotary engine car when it is constantly improving? The rotary engine only got a bad rap when it first came out in the 70s, but it's not the same engine today. And I say give it a go, and thank you for your time.